very quiet. It's starting to get hard to see. But so begins our sordid fable of the cruel family.
Pay attention, all you listening,
to events as we proceed.
As our tale unfolds before you,
at the Humoral Parlor,
on the corner of the street. Quincy, and he embalms the dead. He lives in fear of gangsters because of gambling debts. With some suspense, we shall commence and witness all their fate. We will try to disappoint, but you have no choice, for now you can't escape. Yes, at the
$1,500.
Right, that sounds about right. $1,500. $1,500? Hold on just a minute. When we first discussed the glorious occasion of my mother-in-law's funeral, you said it would only be about $700. Where is this extra coming from?
Mr. Wentworth, funerals are high in demand in this town, and when demand goes up, so do the prices.
That's absolutely ridiculous! You expect me to pay all that just because you stuffed a woman's ashes in an urn and let us pretend like we cared about her for a few hours?
Mr. Wentworth, I'm sorry you feel like you've been taken advantage of, but if you'll indulge me with a moment of your time, I'd like you to try and see things from my point of view. You think the job is simple. You think the job's a breeze. You think I've overcharged you. I'm a con man, I'm a sleaze, but it's much more complicated. So I'll spell it out for you. For every funeral service, exactly what I do. Who has to order urns and caskets and get pastors for the masses? Who turns the bodies into ashes? It's the funeral director. Who has to deal with the arrangements for flowers, prayer cards, and have patience for those who hesitate on payments? It's the funeral director. Now, as the funeral director, I've got a lot of things to do. But when it's your time, I'll be nearby. So when you die, I will bury you. Every day there's someone dying, so my job doesn't ever end. So here's advice, why not play nice? Just take my price, and you'll be my friend. Family, help me explain it to you.
Keeps the funerals running smoothly, and should be paid for his dues. Even if there is missing jewelry, it's the funeral director.
Now, as the funeral director, he's got a lot to oversee. But don't be concerned with what we earn. When it's your turn, you can't disagree. Cost is too outlandish.
But services are always bad.
Yes, the price is high.
And you are mine.
If you were alive, you'd be impressed.
This is absurd. I'm not paying these high prices.
Oh, but you have no choice.
What?
Mr. Wentworth, let me explain something to you. The cost of death is always on the rise. And folks like you will never be satisfied. Turn us down, but here's the catch. We're the only parlor around.
Praise upon the meek and grieving, with his costs always increasing. Who basically goes around thieving is the funeral director. Who thinks that funerals are funny, doesn't care who he takes from me, will end up taking all your money is the funeral director.
At the next funeral. Who knows? Maybe it'll be yours.
Yes, I put the fun into funeral. Cause I'm the funeral director.
Did you see the look on his face?
Priceless.
He wishes our services were priceless.
But funerals aren't free.
They certainly aren't short either.
Not like you were there for most of it anyway.
Speaking of, neither was Corrine. Any chance you two were,
Why would you say that? Or try to imply that we were? Never! We were just arranging the supply closet.
Oh, of course. I must have been mistaken. Guess you two were arranging the supply closet together last Monday during Mrs. Anderson's funeral as well.
Oh, shut up! Don't you have a body to play with?
I don't seem to be the only one.
I've got the mail! 2 letters for Maxim and 1 letter for Sarah from her sister. She's having an excellent time in Florida.
Did you read my mail?
And a very scary-looking envelope for Quincy.
For Quincy? He doesn't get any mail.
I get mail sometimes.
Who's it from?
None of your business. That's who it's from.
It's from the collections office at the racetrack.
I will be taking that.
Looks like someone owes money.
How much do you owe them exactly?
Oh, not sure. It's probably not too much. I'll just add it to the pie.
Quincy, if you don't pay them soon.
I know. The next funeral will be mine. Yeah. But I'm going to win big soon. I can feel it. Then I'll pay my debts, have enough money to leave behind my days of embalming.
Well, this is the profession you chose.
Yes, ever since I was little, I always dreamed of draining corpses and stuffing them with cotton.
Quincy, the undertaking business is in our blood. We were destined for it ever since Grandpa opened up this parlor here in town because of the business opportunities it held for him.
You mean all the violence and death?
Yes, what else would that be referring to? We live off the dead. It's the humoral family business.
I thought the family business was overcharging the grieving.
Well, that too.
Hey everyone! Look at this headline! Some guy named Mr. Hughes is opening up a new funeral home in the next town over!
What?
What does it say?
Hello, I'm Mr. Hughes and I am opening up a parlor. I promise all my funerals are low cost as can be. To celebrate this grand event, we're offering a special. Coffins are buy one, get one free! So why not bring your dead to me?
Another funeral parlor? But we've never had a two-town arrival to deal with before.
Yeah, doesn't Mr. Hughes know this is our territory?
Oh, it's only one funeral home. We might take some of our patrons, but not all of them. I'm sure there's absolutely no way this will affect us at all.
I hope so.
Our business has been booming, so we've got a new location. It's got a gorgeous chapel and a dog for therapy. To open this brand new parlor, all our herbs have been discounted, and soon we'll have parlor number 3! So why not bring your dead to me?
That price is not unreasonable for a funeral, especially with all the choices that you've made.
Well, we'll just see about that. I'm taking my business elsewhere!
Oh, where are you going to go? We're the only funeral parlor in town.
Not anymore, you're not!
We open one downtown right next to Golden Acres Nursing Home.
All services for residents are 20% off.
And now he's opened up another because his other homes are full.
Join our loyalty program and your 10th cremation's free.
He's one right near the lumber mill.
The shooting range.
And hospital.
What can I say? They're just dying to get in.
But the problem is...
Please, Mrs. Hutch.
How can I be?
No, don't hang up.
He's stolen all potential funerals.
Business will endure, but one small family's hurting and is far worse off than ever. I'm worried our future is unsure. I know that I am sounding selfish, but dying isn't cheap, and we are used to having money from our undertaking streak. These other parlors all have prices that are lower, and we can't compete. I'm losing faith, now it's too late. Our future's never looked so bleak. I fear we'll be evicted from our corner of the street. It's the downfall of the humorals. We haven't had a funeral in weeks. Why doesn't anybody bring their dead to me?
Idea what a funeral director has to deal with?
Who has to have tremendous patience for planning all of the arrangements? Who do you think deserves his payment?
Not you!
Mrs. Turner, please, funerals aren't cheap.
They are at Mr. Hughes's parlors. You all have turned this establishment into a scam, and your father would be ashamed at what you've done to his business. This parlor used to be respectable. Why, my mother's funeral was held here. She was laid out in a fine mahogany casket with velvet lining and beautiful white lilies.
And gorgeous jewelry you picked out yourself.
Yes! My mother said she always wanted to look her best. She told me she specifically wanted to be buried wearing my grandmother's brooch. Is that my grandmother's brooch?
What? This old thing? No, of course, I'm not wearing it. It's hers. Mine!
Ooh, they overcharged so much for that funeral, I paid for a new car.
Oh, we can do 600.
500.
Any 100.
Any price.
Not any price.
I'll throw in a free funeral wreath.
I'll throw in a free brooch.
Good day, Mr. and Miss Humoral.
What was that all about?
I don't know. My sister gave me this. I don't know what she was going on about.
We steal from the living, not the dead.
That's right. And what's wrong with it? Tipsy little bit of price gouging. How else am I supposed to run a business? She's the fifth one this week to rob to Mr. Hughes. If things don't change, we're going to be in trouble.
Like we aren't already.
Thank you for calling the Humoral Funeral Parlor. How can I help you? Just a moment. Mr. Humoral, someone's on the phone for you. Someone from the bank.
I'll answer it in the office.
Okay.
Yeah, I hear the phone ring.
Yep, it was for Mr. Humoral.
Give me the gossip. Any idea who it was?
The bank.
Oh, dear.
Maybe it was someone calling about a funeral.
What?
I don't think it's about a funeral.
You won't believe what just happened to me. I went down to the country club and they wouldn't let me in. We've been kicked out. Apparently you and Dad never paid our monthly dues.
We figured food was a bit more important than a country club.
Well, I disagree. What am I supposed to do cooped up in this house?
You could look for a job your father and I didn't give you.
Don't say something so awful.
Well, now don't panic. I know things aren't looking so great. We might not have a country club anymore, and we might not have made any money over the past few months, but we've got each other. Well, at least we still have the house.
Sarah, the bank is reclaiming our house. They're going to be taking us to court.
What? Are you serious?
No, they actually called to congratulate us on going broke.
Well, that's weird of them to do.
This is a nightmare. I can only imagine what Dad would say to me if he was alive and could see the mess I've made.
He'd probably say something like, I always knew you'd fail, Maxim. See, no need to imagine it, just heard it.
It's not your fault, Maxim.
Mom's right! It's those new parlors! How dare someone try to offer reasonable prices to the grieving?
Yeah!
How dare he run us out of business?
Yeah!
How dare he make you feel like the failure your father always thought you were destined to be! Was that not right?
Corrine, why don't we head to the kitchen and make lunch?
But I'm not even hungry.
I know, but we should get you out of the line of fire.
Oh, okay.
Cheer up, Maxim.
How can I cheer up? Business is bankrupt, and now we're gonna lose the family home. Dad's probably looking down and laughing at me.
Or looking up, depending where he is now.
It's all my fault.
I'm glad you're finally admitting it, Maxim.
It's not you! It's Mr. Hughes' fault! Dad, I'm sure we'll have customers again. Just like in those good old days when we were making money. I remember them like they were yesterday. People were drinking, then they end up thinking, why not take a drive so we can get our kicks? And as they were driving, they would end up dying, since we know that alcohol and cars don't mix. Yeah, it would be a real tragedy, but we would feel a grave. It was unhealthy, but we all were wealthy. No, we didn't care back in them good old days. The good old days, everyone was broken. The good old days, and money we were broken. The good old days, but now we all are hoping that we will get back there to them good old days.
Oh man, those were the days.
Yeah, now all those people are with Mr. Hughes. Thanks for reminding me.
Uncle Quincy, do you have any stories about the old days? Of course I do. Those were some of the brightest days in history. This town was violent. We got lots of clients from the victims that were killed for some ways.
The obituaries, all the kind of scary people would get shot or stabbed and we get paid.
If we don't have a funeral soon, the parlor won't be saved.
We just need a killing,
then we could get billing.
God, I really miss them simple good old days.
The good old days, gosh, they were a blessing. The good old days,
money was refreshing.
The good old days,
and now we all are stressing.
God, we really miss them simple good old days.
Those days were filled with bliss, and they are sorely missed.
Yes, we can reminisce, but they're just memories. We must do something soon, or else we all will lose to that damn Mr. Hughes and the boiler's history.
Wait a minute!
Yes, it'll be gone. The parlor will be history.
No, the parlor is history. What are you talking about?
The parlor's been in this town for decades. It's like a historic monument. Maybe if we could get someone to say that our funeral home is a landmark for the town, the bank wouldn't be able to seize it.
I don't know.
What other options do we have?
We think
It's over, cause we're in foreclosure, but us resilient humorals are not done yet. We'll take legal action, we'll make it an attraction. Yes, we'll make our house like a museum of death.
I doubt that any of this could work,
but it could be the only way.
Alright, it's decided,
now I'm all excited.
Thank the Lord we thought about the good old days.
The good old days, our business might be fading. The good old days, trying to be persuading. The good old days,
saving by living off the glory of the good old days.
Oh, the good old days, everybody loved them. The good old days, too bad we are free of them. The good old days, we certainly need more of them. And hopefully we'll get back to the good old days, cause we were living larger in the good old days. God, we really miss them simple good old days. God, we really miss them simple good old days.
Forget about lunch, Sarah. There's work to be done.
What do you mean?
We're having the house declared a historic monument so the bank can't seize it.
Really? Oh, that's brilliant. How can I help? Oh, I know. I'll collect old documents from when your grandfather bought the house. Maybe some old photos.
Don't worry about a thing, Sarah. We can handle it ourselves.
But... well, good luck, Ben.
Where did everyone go? Don't they want lunch?
They're in the office working.
Is everything okay, Mrs. Humoral?
Everything's fine, Corrine.
Okay, well, if you say so, I think I'll take my lunch break. Are you sure everything's okay, Mrs. Humoral?
Yes, Corrine, I'm fine.
Okay. You're sure there's nothing you want to talk about?
What?
The sign thing. It... never mind. Oh, you just spit it out already!
Okay, Corrine, but only if you really want me to. You know how we might have hit a bit of a rough patch with the parlor?
I'm aware.
Well, Maxim is taking it all on as his fault, and it feels like he doesn't even want me to help him.
Maybe he just doesn't want you to be worried.
Well, I'm worried! I mean, we haven't had a funeral in ages. We have almost no money. And Maxim can barely function with all this stress, and... I need some new jewelry.
You really want to buy new jewelry that bad?
Yes. Buy? What else would I be referring to?
Is it really that big of a deal if you and Mr. Humoral aren't as rich as you were before? I mean, it's like you only married him for his money.
Well, what if I did? Would that have been so terrible? Besides, even if it was true, which I'm not saying that it is, it was worth it. For the most part.
Jeez, did you even love him?
Of course I did. Do. I do. Do you know how we met? It was at my parents' funeral. They were in a car crash, and my sister was already married, and so I was all on my own. And then, suddenly he was there, and he asked me out, and I thought, why not? And then I fell in love with being rich after we got married, and now that's kind of all I have.
Well, if you want my opinion, which not many people do, but I give it anyway, you should rethink your priorities because it sounds like you've got them all backwards.
I was youthful, dear God, I know I was foolish. I always thought that I knew what was best. And then I only had one option left. But it was all worth the time. It was all worth the stress and the trials that nobody sees.
she disagrees, it can be worth the time.
And after this, the house will be in tip-top shape for the Historical Society. Hopefully this will impress them.
Not sure why the toilets have to be scrubbed, though. Unless they're going to stick their heads in them to see if they're historic, too. Why are we even the ones doing all the cleaning?
Because Mom and Dad are preparing their speech, and I'm certainly not going to do manual labor. Besides, it's been so long since we've had a funeral, you might as well do some work. You know, Corrine, I think I need help dusting my bedroom. For the Historical Society, of course.
No, Robert, not for the people!
Oh, it's just
a professional!
It's just Uncle Quincy, he's not a person!
actually, Robert, I was thinking maybe we could do out something outside the bedroom.
What's there to do outside the bedroom?
Well, I don't know. Maybe we can go to dinner and then see a show, you know? A date.
A date? Oh, Corrine. Let's not ruin what we have. Besides, you and I could never work out romantically.
Why not?
Well, we're from different worlds. I'm from a sophisticated family. I mean, I went to prep school, and you, well,
You're poor.
And what exactly are you and your family right now?
Oh, this is just a temporary thing. We're not actually poor like you.
Smooth, Robert.
What, did I say something wrong?
Corrine, would you bring out the food from the kitchen for our guests?
Of course, Mr. Humoral.
It's gotten her all upset. Robert, what did you do?
Nothing!
Whatever he did, she'll get over it. Are you ready?
Ready to have our fate decided? Ready to find out if we get to keep our house? Can't wait. We've got to try our best today.
Now it's we.
Guess I'm fine.
What was that?
Nothing. Here's the food!
That's it? That's just a bowl of
nuts! Well, isn't much like... Oh, before I forget, I picked up the mail. Nothing really important except for bills, foreclosure notices, and another collection notice for Quincy.
Can't you snoop through somebody else's mail?
I could, but the foreclosure notices are just so upsetting.
How much do you owe exactly?
Doesn't say. Just a friendly reminder.
You have 1 week to pay before we break your legs. Do they normally write out their clippings of newspaper with their notes?
It's fine. I'm sure they'll stop once they get paid.
And when exactly will that be?
Once I get paid.
Then you better start looking for another job. Oh god, is that them already? They're early.
I'm looking for Mr. Maxim Humoral.
That would be me. I'm Mr. Maxim Humoral. You're from the Historical Society, correct? I'm so sorry. I thought I had a little more time to get ready. How do you do?
No. My name is Henry Hughes. I'm the owner of Henry Hughes's Happy Funeral Home.
So, we finally meet.
Yes, the pleasure is all mine. Might I have a moment with you?
What's this about? I'm a very busy man.
Oh, of course. What with all the funeral services you've got lined up.
If all you're going to do is insult me, then
oh, forgive me, Mr. Humoral, but I do come bearing a gift. A proposition, if you will.
What are you talking about?
I hear you're not doing well because...
We're fine.
We're great.
And your last funeral was... just what I thought. Seems to me times have gotten tough for you, Mr. Funeral Director.
Just get to the point already.
The cost of all my services are low. And your response to my competition's been, well, slow. I've stolen all of your accounts, and now you're suffering from a drought. But you have got one final chance, cause I'm here waiting on a branch. Your partner can't compete with mine, so here's my pitch. I think it's time for you to resign.
We're doing just fine.
Oh, really? Which one has funerals more often, while you can't even fill one coffin? Whose profits show no signs of stopping? Me, the funeral director. And I got a lot of things to do, but I thought I'd try to see if I maybe could buy your home from you. Cause this kindly funeral director is here to help you out of debt. So here's advice, why not play nice? Just take my price, you'll have no regrets.
Sell to you? No, that's not happening.
Well, you might not have a choice if you can't find a way to drum up business around here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have services to attend to, bodies to bury, payments to collect. I'm sure you remember how much work funerals are. I'll be expecting a call soon. Just take my prize. It's the best you're gonna get.
Waltzing in here expecting us to just hand over our home to him? I mean, what a ridiculous notion! As if we're just gonna let him take it from us for next to nothing.
Maybe we shouldn't refuse his offer so quickly.
What do you mean?
Well, I can't be the only one thinking it, right? If he's offering us enough, I'm not saying we take it it right away, but maybe we shouldn't turn it down without discussing it together.
There's nothing to discuss, Sarah. I won't give up my family's home, my family's legacy, not that easily, and not to someone like him.
But what if things don't work out with the Historical Society? We've barely got enough money to live off of, and with no business, maybe we've got to cut our losses and run.
Look, everything will work out, you'll see. Okay, we won't have to sell to Mr. Hughes, I promise. Now, do we all know the plan?
Yes!
Yes.
When they arrive, I will answer the door, graciously take their coats, and offering a beverage. Then I will wait in the kitchen, waiting to serve coffee in case I hear things going badly to help ease the tension.
You and I shall explain why the parlor should be granted historic landmark status, and pray they don't realize it's a business stunt.
I shall be standing by, ready to help with the tour of the home and the demonstration of the embalming instruments.
And I shall remain out of the way.
Excellent. Hopefully this will all go over well. Places, everyone.
Right,
right, right.
Welcome, please. Ah, Mr. Humoral!
What is it?
Mr. Humoral, she doesn't have a coat. How can I follow the plan if she doesn't have a coat I can graciously take? Do I even offer a beverage?
Can't be serious. Just adapt and forget about any coats.
Oh, you're right. This is why you're the boss. I do apologize for my small outburst. I was just taken off guard by the lack of your proper protection from the cold weather. Can I offer you an ice-cold beverage?
Queen?
I'm sorry, I'm just so nervous.
Just go check on something in the kitchen. Welcome. How wonderful to receive you. My name is Maxim Humoral, and I'm the owner of this funeral parlor. This is my wife, Sarah.
Hello.
And you're here to appraise the house, correct?
Yes, Mr. and Mrs. Humoral. My name is Janet Norcross, and I am the representative from the Association for Significant Structures, or the ASS.
I'm sorry, the AS.
We are aware of the unfortunate way that acronym could be interpreted and are working to change it. I'll be the one to review your proposal to see if your parlor is worthy of becoming a historic landmark. Or not.
Yes, of course.
Are you hungry? We have hors d'oeuvres.
Oh, heavens, what are those?
The nuts.
Is that an almond? Get those away from me! I am deadly allergic to almonds!
Oh, yes. No!
Do something about them!
Right,
What's that yelling? I heard it's a time for coffee!
Take these away at once!
But I...
Oh, why? How would you dare you serve these four distinguished guests when she clearly has a nut allergy?
But
just
I...
get rid of them!
Are you trying to kill me? If I were to ever eat an almond, I'd die almost instantly!
No, of course not! How are we supposed to know you were allergic to almonds?
I suppose that is a fair point. Well, I might as well start this appraisal before either of you kill me. Now then, I noticed such beautiful architectural design, wonderful Victorian-era details, the decorative trim. It's absolutely gorgeous. Is it neoclassical or Baroque inspired?
How could I be so foolish? It's Gothic Revival! I can barely tell from the tacky decorating that's happened since this poem was built. Oh, when was it built?
Around 1890.
I should have known from the octagonal roof of the tower. Right, now I will have to take a tour. But before we do all that, I have to ask the important questions. This funeral home, has anyone of importance had their funeral here?
Well, there was Washington.
Someone related to George Washington was buried here? Oh my goodness, which Washington?
A childhood dog, Washington?
Uh-huh. Was this parlor involved in any historic war?
Well, there was my parents' divorce.
Has anything of any historical significance ever happened here?
No, but... Sarah, would you care to answer?
We like to think of each funeral as a historically significant event. They're all small testaments to the town's history. This town's very violent history of excessive murder.
So, that's all, then. You think this funeral home is a historical monument because It's been here for decades, and that's it? Mr. and Mrs. Humoral, we at the ASS do not appreciate this waste of our time. Why are you even trying to have this parlor declared a historic landmark?
To preserve history.
Is this some sort of business stunt?
No, of course not.
You see, we might have hit a rough patch financially, and the parlor could be taken from us. So we were hoping that if the parlor was declared a historical monument,
it could be protected from demolition.
So it could help benefit the town, bring in tourists, help us remember the violence that has occurred here, help
benefit yourselves.
You would never do that.
Oh, please, I can see right through you both. You're not the first business to try and do this. How dare you waste the ASS's time? There's nothing historic about this. This tacky parlor, is there?
Tacky? I decorated this place myself.
Well, you've got terrible taste.
Excuse me?
I hear some yelling. Coffee? Mm-hmm. I'll ease the tension.
It's a little late for that. And why are you serving coffee? Where's Corrine?
She wouldn't leave the kitchen. She kept saying something about not wanting to ruin the mission.
Oh, coffee! I can never turn down a free cup. It's my one vice. I'll have some before I go. Extra milk.
Away.
Ms. Norcross, please, let's get back on topic. The parlor...
It's not receiving historic landmark status today or any other day. Your home doesn't deserve such a distinguished honor.
But consider how important this service is that we provide to this town. For decades, this parlor has stood on this corner, preserving the dead and deceased. But now it's appearing as though we might join them and end up on the streets.
So that is why we're asking sweetly, since you're the only hope we've got.
Though we might have treated our patrons all poorly, we don't
deserve to rot.
We don't deserve this unfair treatment.
We don't deserve this shame. And if we were foreclosed, then heaven only knows what that would do to our name.
Insignificant? This was once the premier location for funerals.
And it goes bankrupt under your ownership. Seems to me you don't know how to run a business.
Temper,
Maxim, temper. How about another cup of coffee? I insist.
Well, all right, but just one more. Well, this caffeine is making me tingly.
That's odd, it's decaf.
Right, well, anyhow, Mr. and Mrs. Humoral, I think you're both being a tad overdramatic.
Our lives are depending upon your compassion. We desperately need relief.
Control yourself!
Sorry.
We haven't had business, and now we are facing
a bleak reality.
And why exactly should I help you? It's not a historic estate. You've lied to me, and you have wasted my time, so I don't care about your fate.
Wait!
We don't deserve this unfair treatment. Our parlor.
Or our precious town.
But we don't deserve this unfair treatment.
I understand your pitch, but I made up my mind. Your proposal is declined, and I will never switch.
You horrid, awful!
More coffee! Anyone! Just in time before someone says something they might regret.
Thank you.
Cieri, you've got to control yourself. You almost blew it.
Me?
Yes, you do. You're going to ruin this. I should have just done this myself.
Isn't this coffee delicious? Flavors all in the creamer.
Delightful. Is it vanilla?
Yes, it is vanilla. And one other flavor. What was that? That's right. Almond. Yeah, it's vanilla almond milk.
Almonds?
Oh my god, I know I love almonds too. Oh, you know what? We're all out. I'm gonna go get some more. You stay there. I'm gonna go fill this up. Don't you move.
Miss Norcross, please, won't you reconsider?
We are not done.
I think that you're helping this man to install somehow.
Perfect, but darling, you floundered before I stepped in.
Sarah, let's not do that.
out, she died.
Shit! What are you doing?
Call 911!
Right! What is the doper?
Oh, give me that!
She could barely speak with her throat all swollen.
Either way, she'll be out of our hair as soon as the coroner finishes inspecting her body in the morgue.
Hopefully she finishes up soon.
Sarah, that necklace there, wasn't Miss Norcross wearing one that looked just like it?
No, I don't think so. I've had this for ages, wear it all the time. And you didn't even notice until now! I specifically wore it today because you always tell me how much you like it. Do you ever pay attention, Maxim?
Sarah, I'm sorry, I'm so distracted. I
understand. Let's not talk about this or my necklace ever again. Consider it forgiven and forgotten.
Bye.
It's forgotten!
And if it was hers, it's not doing her much good now.
Well, Mr. Humoral, I think I'm about finished up here, going over my notes. There's no doubt that Miss Norcross's death is nothing more than an unfortunate accident.
Oh, thank God I'm not going to jail!
Thank you, Dr. Warner. Is there anything else you need from us?
No, Mr. Humoral. And thank you again for letting us store her remains in your morgue. Who would have thought the city morgue would ever be full? Being a funeral director in this town must make you a fortune.
Certainly used to.
Well, I've got to head back to my office and write up her death certificate. Never thought I'd write almond milk as a cause of death. Have a good day, Mr. and Mrs. Earl.
And what about you, Detective Booker? Do you need anything else from us?
No, but I'll have to stick around for a bit. Her nephew will be by soon to formally identify the body and decide what to do with her. In the meantime, could I have a cup of coffee while I wait?
Of course. Come with me to the kitchen. I'll make you one. No almonds.
That's it. Don't worry, though. We'll figure something else out to save the house.
Something else?
Yeah, I'm not giving up just yet.
I think we only have one option left.
And that is?
I think that we should call Mr. Hughes and have him come back to discuss his offer.
What?
We can at least hear the man out.
Absolutely not. That is out of the question, and this is not your decision to make.
Oh, so this isn't my home, then? I have no say in any of this.
That's not what I'm saying, Sarah, but this is not your family's legacy that built this place.
And you constantly remind me of that. I have always respected your family legacy, but now we have to face the facts. The plan that the Historical Society went up in smoke. Our savings are almost gone. We've been given an out that can actually help us, but it's up to you to decide.
I'm not accepting it!
Fine. If you want to sit around and wait to lose the house, be my guest, but don't expect me to stick around for that.
Sarah, wait! I can't do anything right, can I? Nothing that I do works. I failed myself, the business. And her. This is the failure of a man. One who could not foresee his fall. He thought he kept his kingdom safe from threats beyond the wall. And now he's forced to see the truth. He really never had a plan. A folly and a failure of a man. The danger there all along. How did this come to pass? Now I've become the prey, and I can feel my Sarah slipping away.
down off his throne, and now must sacrifice his pride or lose all that he owns. And there's no way that I can win, given the choice I have at hand, all cause of one small failure of a man.
What the heck is wrong with them? They're both acting like babies. What the heck is wrong with them?
morbid reason I'm even here.
Oh, why's that?
I'm here for my great aunt, Miss Norcross.
The lady we accidentally killed. Oh, I'm so sorry. She's waiting downstairs in the morgue for you. Come along, my sweet.
We heard the doorbell ring. Is Miss Norcross's nephew here?
Yes, he's right here. This is Nathaniel. Nathaniel Ramsey. He's here to pick up his, this is her nephew. Yes, he's. I'm following him to the morgue now. You can follow me, darling.
Look at him, following her like a sad little dog. Wait for me!
I should probably go with them.
I've decided to sell.
You have?
Yes. I called Mr. Hughes and he should be here shortly to sign all the paperwork.
Well, I'm sorry, Maxim. I know that couldn't have been an easy decision.
You were right. It's better that we get out now and start over someplace else. That'll be him, I suppose.
Well. I have to admit, I didn't expect to be back here so soon, but here I am.
You seem pretty chipper for kicking us out of our own home.
I'm offering you help, Maxim. Don't blame me for your problem. You have the contract ready?
It's right here.
Oh, Maxim Humoral, you have no idea how happy you're about to make me. Now just sign right there and I'll sign my section and you'll be done with the undertaking business. And then your house will become one of the newest locations of Henry Hughes's happy funeral homes.
All right, let's just get this over with.
Mr. and Mrs. Humoral, Nathaniel has formally identified Miss Norcross's body. Since our morgues are full, we'll have to leave the body in your care until we can make some room for it, if that's okay with you.
Yes, that's fine.
Right then. My report's all finished here, so I'll be on my way. You have my number if you need to reach me for any reason. Good day, Mr. and Mrs. Humoral.
Thank you, Detective.
A body?
Yes, we had an unfortunate accident this morning. Someone had an allergic reaction to some almonds and passed away, so we're storing her here in our morgue until her nephew could identify her.
Oh my. I'm so incredibly sorry for your loss. Do you know who will be in charge of planning your aunt's funeral?
I'll be in charge of handling the arrangements.
They're having her nephew plan the whole thing? Doesn't she have anyone else closer to her?
No one in the family really liked her.
She didn't seem like quite the ASS.
Well then, sir, my name is Mr. Hughes, and I run the funeral parlors in town. Well, all but one, but soon to be all. I promise that after we transfer your aunt to one of my homes for a small transportation fee, we will deliver an exceptional funeral.
I'm sorry, did you say transportation fee?
Oh, yes. Well, it's standard for moving any and all human remains.
Well, that seems a bit silly to pay to move a body from one funeral home to the next. Why not just have her funeral here?
What?
Well, if you have an opening.
We do!
But, sir, you can't be serious.
Oh, no, he sounds real serious to me. Wait. Does that mean we really have a funeral, a real live funeral? Oh, I could kiss you!
Please don't.
Okay.
Well, hold on a minute, Maxim. Remember what we're about to do.
Make a mistake, that's what. Mr. Hughes, we aren't selling.
Wait! Were you about to sell the parlor without telling any of us?
Yes, but it doesn't matter now because we're not selling.
We're not?
We're not.
Oh, thank God that awful, stingy, old, snobbish woman died here.
Maxim! Why don't I head into the office and help Nathaniel pick arrangements for Ms. Norcross's funeral before you say something to turn our valued patron away? Nathaniel, Corrine and I will go through all the different arrangements and the options available, caskets, florists, music, what she'll be wearing. And that reminds me, did she have any nice jewelry she'd like to be buried in?
Oh, lots. She was a big fan of gold.
Excellent. So am I. Right this way.
Mr. Hughes, I think it's time you left.
All right, Maxim. But you and I both know one funeral is not going to save your parlor. How much will you honestly earn if few hundred? How many bills will that cover before you're right back here again?
This time we'll be smarter. We'll figure something else out.
Oh, this is only going to prolong the inevitable, Maxim, and we both know that. You're going to need a lot more people to accidentally die here before you drum up enough business to save yourself. I'll give it a month tops before I'm back here again. In the meantime, you know how to reach me when you finally decide to sell. Good day, Max.
Please, let me be foolish enough to end up here.
You're being foolish if you think he's wrong.
Quincy, can't you just let me have one small victory?
You're right. I shouldn't be so negative. After all, we finally got a real-life funeral on our hands.
And just think, it's all because you gave Miss Norcross almond milk and killed her.
Accidentally.
We didn't even get in trouble for it.
Mr. Hughes is right, though. We need a lot more people to accidentally die here to turn our luck around. I mean, they'd already be in a funeral home. It only makes sense for us to host the funerals.
But we don't have the time or money to sit around and wait for accidents to happen. In case you haven't noticed, we're about to lose our house.
I suppose so. Nice thought.
It would be funny, though, but I guess we can't just wait around for, What if we didn't wait for accidents?
What?
What a shame. What a waste. That us humorals can't change our fates. Look at us, we're all spent. But if people died from accidents, here I'm standing and here I'm thinking how we all might be saved. Here I'm standing and here I'm thinking how we might fill some graves. If more people died here, our troubles would stop. Our parlor could once again rise to the top. If people arrived and died, well, isn't it clear? Then we would host all their funerals here.
Are you suggesting what I think you're suggesting?
Depends on what you think I'm suggesting.
I think you're suggesting that we kill people.
No, Quincy, I wouldn't suggest that. But, on the other hand, people were invited to the parlor and wound up in certain situations where they would perish, like Miss Norcross. All we'd have to do is sit around and just
what? Let them die.
Exactly! Let them die!
Let who die?
Well, whoever we choose, let them die. Though their families might cry, it would give us a chance when they die. It could grant us humorals, brand new funerals, if we set up some traps. We'd lure in prey, and then we'd stage it as a fatal mishap. So they'll die, yes, they'll die. It technically won't be a crime.
Dad, that's absolutely ridiculous. Maxim, I can't go through with your work. There's not one word you can say that convinced me.
Really? Not even paying off your gambling debts?
That's five words. Wait, what?
Here I'm standing and here I'm thinking you're in over your head. If we don't do what I'm proposing, well,
then I might end up dead. And what do I care?
Anything you want.
What he wants is to get Corrine back.
Yeah, how would murdering help with that?
Well, Corrine chose Nathaniel for what he provides. But if we had money,
then she would be mine.
To get what you want, I've learned you can't be afraid. So that's why we must go mutilate. Let them die, let them die. Even if it feels wrong, let them die. Cause all we want in life would require their small sacrifice. I'll pay you all sorts if you bring me a corpse. Your wants could all manifest. You could have the world pay your debts when the girl
but it's wrong.
It's not right.
Hurting others because of our plights.
But I mean,
then again,
why should we suffer
when it could be them?
I suppose
there'd be no debts for me. And if I win Corrine, let them die,
let them die.
If we get what we want, let them die. And then once they've all died, we'll get rich and we'll be satisfied.
We'll go along with it then.
Yeah, why not? What am I got to lose?
If you don't pay your debts, you're alive.
Oh, will we tell the others, Sarah, Corrine?
No, Corrine can't keep a secret to save her life. And Sarah wouldn't be on board with this. She's never done anything criminal in her life.
Okay, you got it. It's our secret. So, who exactly will be, you know, first?
Well, let's see. I think this parlor could use a new look, don't you?
Oh.
Here I'm standing and here I'm thinking we should repaint this room. We'll hire a painter and set it up so he dies inhaling paint fumes.
Oh, an unlucky gardener could fall on his shears.
A clumsy repairman could easily die here.
If we kill enough so that demand rises high, well,
that's when we'll have to raise our price. Let them die, let them die. We'll ensnare them in traps and
assistance.
It will bring us business. A funeral would be grand.
Yes, it will, sure would.
Of course, it's not murder.
We're silent observers.
Oh, what a marvelous plan. Cause they'll die. Yes, they'll die. I'm so happy, I think I could cry. Knowing that I'll get paid once they
disgusting.
We must ask, wait patiently.
This is just the intermission, and the show is not complete. We'll return to end this story at the Humoral Funeral Parlor on the corner of the street.
Undertaker has been on a killing spree with his faithful son and brother at the funeral parlor on the corner of the street.
Ah, you must be here to fix the chandelier in the office. Do be careful though, the wires are exposed and it's very dangerous. You could electrocute yourself in an unfortunate accident.
Hi, ma'am. I'm sorry, but it seems your husband died. The wire tried to fix it, then somehow got fried. Yes, monthly payment plans are something we provide. $1,000, that should suffice. Good things are happening, I think we'll be okay. Good lord, the guilt and feelings causing such a strain. But good thing, embalming fluids don't ever decay. So we finally have a funeral to throw today. We've got a funeral today. Thriving off another's pain, but there's no reason for dismay. And all our work is not in vain for us, dear Humorals.
Cause we got a funeral today.
We've been so busy, Mr. Humoral.
Yes, well, it seems every time someone comes to the parlor, they somehow die.
Accidentally!
Don't forget, someone's coming to fix the roof this afternoon.
To it is from the upstairs balcony. Do be careful though, it's rather slippery. You could fall, we wouldn't want that now. Oh my.
Hi sir, it seems your son fell off from roof above. No sir, he slipped, I promise that we didn't shove. Yes, doing cremations is something that we love. $1,200, that should be enough.
Oh, Robert, please remember to be well-behaved. Oh, Maxim, look at you, your tie's in disarray.
Oh, Father, who's the next one we'll exterminate?
What?
Shh, we have a funeral to throw today.
We've got a funeral today. This morning service will be great.
People are
driving. I will, in fact,
Maxim, still so far away.
And I have arranged a bouquet.
And my embalming's on display.
It's our big renewal, cause we got a funeral today.
Sarah's wedding ring.
Don't be silly, Maxim. I've had this for ages. Remember to avoid the basement. The plumber is coming to fix the pipes this afternoon.
All right. All right. Here to inspect the pipes downstairs? I must warn you, the stairs to the basement are very old and unstable. They might collapse and you could get hurt. Or worse. Yes,
and I even burned away his stake.
And Robert, you booked Father Damon.
Wait, was that my obligation?
Oh God, I think I'm gonna need a drink.
Don't worry, Maxim, I can call a priest. We still have plenty of time.
No, we don't. The family's here.
What? We're not ready.
We don't have a pastor.
I'll have to conduct the services.
Do you think you can do it?
What does a priest do? They read from a book and everyone pretends to pay attention. It's simple. Now, everyone, let's get this place ready.
We've got a funeral today, and soon we all will celebrate. People are dying, and we're supplying. A grieving family's on their way. Oh, at the top is where we'll stay, because we're finally getting paid.
Thank you.
act somber. Be respectful. And above all else, if someone in the family needs a tissue, it's 25 cents a pop. Now, I'll pick out some Bible verses for the readings. Sarah and Quincy, keep the line moving. All right, Corrine, get them anything they need. And Robert,
yeah.
Don't make a mess of anything.
Right.
Right.
Maxim? Hmm? Oh, Sarah, I don't know what passages to read for this funeral. Maybe I'll just pick a random line. He will be thrown into the blazing furnace where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Maybe not that one.
Is there anything I can help with?
No, Sarah, it's fine. I don't need you.
Oh. You mean you don't need my help?
That's what I said, wasn't it? Sarah, is that a new watch?
This old thing? No, birthday present from my aunt.
And earrings?
These were a wedding present from my sister. Just hadn't worn them till now.
And that necklace?
Hanukkah gift?
But we're Protestants! Sarah, where did you get all these? Please tell me you haven't been spending all of our money. I've been working so hard to get this all red.
I promise I haven't been spending any money on it.
Then how have you been?
I just found some old stuff.
But where did you?
I told you they're gifts! Maxim, I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. I've got other things to worry about anyways.
Are you okay? Is everything all right?
Yes. Everything's fine.
Maxim, you can tell me anything.
I wouldn't be so sure of that.
Why not?
Because...
Mr. Humoral! We have mourners that are getting very anxious and get to work started!
Right. Come on, Sarah, we should get back to my life.
Second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 1, verse 3.
What?
It's a passage about the grieving. The services.
Thank you.
Corrine!
Nathaniel!
Corrine, I must speak with you at once.
Nathaniel, what is it?
Oh, Corrine, there's something I need to ask you. I was going to wait until tonight on our date, but I just can't wait that long. The problem is, I just don't know exactly how to say it.
Just take a deep breath and blurt it out.
Blurt it out? Right here?
No, I want you to go out into the corner of traffic. Of course I mean right here!
Okay, Corrine, leave me.
What did you say?
Corrine, will you marry me?
Come again?
Corrine, will you marry me?
Oh, you just spit it out already!
No, I can't. I'm too nervous.
Well, how the hell are you supposed to ask me what you want to ask?
I know. I'll ask you in song.
Wait, what?
Hit it! And you make me feel complete. So I think it's time I asked you, as I get down on one knee. Oh, Corrine, oh, Corrine, oh, Corrine, can't you see, can't you see, can't you see, that you and I are both meant to be. So Corrine, won't you please marry me?
Nathaniel, we've got a funeral going on in the next room, and I don't think an up-tempo is really appropriate. I think you should be going.
But you haven't answered yet.
Oh, right.
You love me, but I see it isn't so. And if we're not getting married, then I guess I'd better go.
I feel weak. I'm so nervous I can't breathe. Let's just drop this.
funeral in the next room.
Oh, Mr. Humoral, you'll never guess the happy news.
What is it?
Guess!
You just said I never guessed!
Oh, right. Well, Corrine and I, her and me, we've been engaged.
Engaged?
Engaged?
Engaged!
But Corrine, you're engaged to him?
No, I'm engaged to the sofa. Of course I'm engaged to Nathaniel.
How did he do it?
Well, you know, there was a lot of singing. I got a bit blindsided by it.
No, when's the date?
We haven't discussed any of the details, actually, and, we were too busy singing. There was a lot of singing. I can't stress that enough.
But super. Definitely within a year.
This year?
Or next month.
Next month!
I can't wait to call you my wife. What do you say, Corrine? Soon we shall wed and live happily, but I can't wait for our big wedding, so next month we should get married.
Okay, just stop with the singing, I guess. Next month we're getting married.
And think about how wonderful being married to me shall be.
Oh, yes, it'll be so wonderful. And do you know what else is going to be wonderful? The people in the next room who are paying us big bucks for our funeral. Now, you can discuss your wedding plans later. Everyone be quiet and come help, even you if you're gonna stay.
Of course I'm gonna stay. I'm part of the family now.
And stay quiet.
You got it. Oh, Corrine. I can't believe that you just said you would marry me. Now we can go and live happily.
Inside our cremation furnace while he was trying to repair it. It's almost unbelievable that the door would accidentally shut on its own and the furnace would somehow be set to an automatic timer. Of course, it's a bit ironic that someone with their last name Ashman would go out like that. We've got your brother's ashes right here in this temporary urn. You'll be able to pick out something, you know, a little nicer once we've made the funeral arrangements, but on the bright side, at least you won't have to decide whether or not to have him cremated. This weekend of the funeral service, you know, here's a thought. I swear I just came up with it. Why not have his funeral here? We're a bit, you know, packed at the moment, but I'm sure for the right price we can squeeze him in, and I mean, he's already been cremated here, so I guess it just makes sense to,
Mr. Humoral, I am...
What? Take some time to decide it. I mean, it's something to consider. It's what would be best for you and your family.
But, Mr. Huber, I've already chosen for my brother's funeral.
Oh, well, then why don't we just step into my office and we can start discussing all
of it? She'll be hosting her brother's funeral with me.
Mr. Hughes?
Yes. You see, when poor Mrs. Ashman was notified of her brother's untimely and an almost unbelievably accidental demise. She happened to remember an advertisement I had placed in the newspaper. Now, what was it now? Oh, yes. 50% off all funeral services for accidental deaths.
Mrs. Ashman, is a discounted funeral service really worth it when you could have a quality one right here with us?
Well, my brother did always like to save a few pennies, and it's what he would have wanted.
Yes, it's what he would have wanted, exactly. Now, Maxim, where are her brother's remains? We're here to collect them and transport them back to one of my homes.
Right here.
Excellent. Mrs. Ashman, if you'll be so kind to take them, I'll meet you in the funeral home.
Of course, Mr. Hughes.
Mr. Hughes, that's a very specific deal you're advertising. Any reason why?
Oh, well, it seemed like a logical business move. After all, there have been so many accidental deaths in town. I wanted to capitalize on the market. Funny, they all seem to be happening here. And when they do, coincidentally, you all get a funeral. Oh, one might even suspect you were killing people for business.
Well, you know, accidents do happen.
Okay, we finished cleaning up the furnace. Who's the next victim? Oh, crap.
Oh, my God. You're actually doing it.
I don't know what you're referring to.
Oh my god. Oh my god, Maxim, you're really killing people for business. I meant it as a joke, but to think you're a... I mean, I knew you were a calculating, thieving con man, but my goodness, I never would have pegged you as a murderer. Although it is a smart business move. I'm surprised I hadn't thought of it myself.
So what are you going to do now that you know? Go to the police?
Of course I am. What do you think? I'm going to let you continue on killing half the town just to fill a few grades? It's sick! Ah!
Unless what?
Unless you buy...
How much is that going to cost?
Oh, a very reasonable price. Like, say, all your future funeral profits.
All of our profits?
We'll go bankrupt and be right back to where we started. We'll go out of business.
Oh, look at that. Now you've caught on to my plan.
Why don't you just go to the police and get rid of us that way?
Oh, I could, but where's the fun in all that? Oh, I might as well try to make a bit of money out of this while I can.
Why are you so intent on destroying us?
I'm a businessman, Maxim, and when I see a business opportunity, I take it. And of course, once I've forced you to close down, I'll start upcharging people just like you did. Do you still have that contract I gave you?
It's in my office.
Good. Well, you have your options, and if I don't hear from you within 24 hours, I'll head straight to the police.
You! How did you do this to us?
I'm sorry, I didn't know he was here.
I'm gonna kill you next and not even bother staging it as an accident.
There's no use killing Uncle Quincy. We need to put all our heads together if we're gonna figure out what to do now that Mr. Hughes knows.
I don't know what to do.
Then figure it out. You're the brains behind this whole operation, aren't you?
I know I am! Let me think.
You better think fast.
Oh my god. I can't believe this is so rude. I'm a dead man. What do you mean?
Nothing. I just meant that I could really use the money now more than ever.
For what? Quincy?
Well, I might have continued gambling just a bit.
Quincy, this has to be a joke. You bet using a life insurance policy?
Only as a collateral.
Which they can collect if you can't afford to pay anymore.
Well, how would they collect Uncle Quincy's life insurance if he's still alive? What are they gonna do, kill him? Oh my god, Uncle Quincy, they're gonna kill you. It's really incredible. I didn't think the boy wonder over here would figure it out. But you really managed to surprise me!
Is that supposed to be an insult?
Oh, he's two for two!
Oh, would you both shut up?
Maxim, don't you see why I need the money? They're gonna be coming after me next. I can't, we cannot stop killing now, or it'll be my funeral next.
If we keep on killing, then Mr. Hughes gets all of our profits.
Well, the plan was working fine up until now. It's all Mr. Hughes' fault. I wish he'd just die. That's it. Here I'm standing, and here I'm thinking how this all might get fixed. A way where I could pay off my debts, and we could all remain rich. He's our main competitor, don't you suppose? If we kill him, there's motive, and we'll get exposed. Yes, I know the risk, but what else can we do? I think it's time we killed Mr. Hughes. Let him die. He'd do us no more harm if he dies. And I think you might find we'll be better if Mr. Hughes dies.
See, we can't. Robert, back me up.
Right, we can't kill Mr. Hughes. Unless... Yes, it could help me win back Corrine.
Oh my god!
Here I'm standing, and here I'm thinking how you could benefit.
Barbara, don't listen to him.
Yes, if we kill off Mr. Hughes, I know who's next on our list.
How?
See, if he was gone, he won't stand in our way. Then her rich fiancé would meet with foul play. First kill Mr. Hughes so that he couldn't go tell.
Oh,
and then we'd kill off Nathaniel. Have them die. Yes, they'll die. Mr. Hughes
and Nathaniel
will die. And then once they both die,
I'll get Corey,
pay my debts, and survive.
Oh, hey, Quincy, I'm not on board with this.
You know they're expendable.
You sound nonsensical, and the risk is too great.
But we are in dire with two against one, so you don't have a say.
What if I refuse to kill them?
If you choose to decline, there might be a new victim we'd find.
Someone to substitute.
But who else?
Maybe someone like you.
No, we can't do this anymore.
Dad.
Absolutely not. We've got to lay low, or who knows who else might find out.
You don't understand.
No, we have to stop this, or else we're done for. No more murdering people for business.
What?
Sarah, how long have you been...
So this is what's been going on.
We can explain.
Don't bother. I need a minute alone with my husband.
Sarah, please, it's not what you think. I'll explain everything.
It's about time you do.
It started with Miss Norcross and her untimely death, and what soon quickly followed upon her final breath. Her funeral was held with us, our future grew less dim. Then one small thought sprung in my head, and I knew it was grim. But ever since then, Quincy and I have been living off the dead. I know it's sounding gruesome. We've been murdering away four funerals each day through staged accidents. Yes, we've been living off the dead. But I swear this all will finish. It soon will be over. Then there'll be no more living off the dead.
It's ingenious.
Sarah, I don't think you heard what I said. We've been killing people.
Well, everyone dies. We're just helping them along. And this makes my secret seem like nothing.
Your secret?
Well, it started with our marriage, my love of finer things. And as we grew apart, all I had was jewelry. Despite all those times that you kept me at bay, you need me to clean up this.
death do us part. Now death's a new star to help get ahead. Yes, we are living off the dead. The humoral family business. Now we're in control of our destinies. We knew homicide, but our marriage needs. Now we're living. Because we're killing. Yes, we are living off the dead.
Chances to pay off your debts. I'm not gonna help you if you won't learn. That must be him.
But Maxim, what am I gonna do about Mr. Hughes?
What are you doing here?
I'm here to meet with Maxim and Sarah. They finally made their choice. They're selling the parlor over to me.
What? Maxim?
We've got no choice. He's backed us into a corner, and if we don't do this, he'll turn us over to the police.
It's a shame, really. I was so looking forward to living out the American dream. Making a fortune by exploiting your hard work. Of course, now I know of the horrors that have gone on here, my offer has dropped significantly.
Dad, you can't be serious. What's going to happen to me?
That's enough. We have some business to attend to.
Shall we?
Of course, right this way.
I'll see who that is. You two get started.
What was that all about? Why on earth is he selling the parlor?
Would you both stop asking questions and let us handle it?
Nathaniel. What are you doing here?
I've come to see Corrine. I speak with her at once.
Nathaniel, what's going on?
Corrine, I have something important I need to ask you. I missed you so much.
But you just saw me this afternoon at lunch.
Yes. And I already missed you.
Oh my God.
Corrine, I know we're getting married next month, but I can't stand not being married to you any longer. So I came here to, well, Corrine, let's get married tonight.
What?
What?
I got all the papers right here.
Oh, Nathaniel, I just I'm not ready yet.
Perhaps another surprise can convince you.
No!
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 We need to do something.
We can head straight to City Hall, sign everything, and find someone to marry us.
No, Corrine, don't!
Actually, Corrine, I think it's a fantastic idea.
What?
You do.
Well, you love Nathaniel, don't you? And you've already agreed to marry him.
Right.
So why not rush into it? Spend the rest of your lives together, every morning waking up to the same face, the same things, over and over and over and over and over and over and over. That's what you really want, isn't it?
I.
What do you say, Corrine? Oh, Corrine, oh, Corrine, oh, Corrine.
Stop! Stop it!
You can't do what?
I'd marry you!
Was it the song?
No! Partly. I mean, it's an earworm, but it gets annoying after the 10th time, but no, Nathaniel.
I've been using you too!
What?
until I get married. So I figured I would just ask the first girl I saw to marry me and...
divorce her once you get the money?
Well, when you say it like that, it sounds awful. But accurate, yes.
Big mistake, Nathaniel. It's all over now because Corrine would never...
How much is your trust fund worth?
Well, not much. Only about 10,000.
10,000? Holy crap! You know better how we're getting married tonight!
Really? Tonight?
Yes, and we'll get divorced as soon as you get your money!
Oh, Corrine, I can't believe you've agreed to this! Here are the marriage papers. We'll drive right to town hall and find someone to marry us!
What were you thinking?
I thought she'd crack under the pressure and break it off. I didn't know this would happen instead.
Oh, Nathaniel! This is just so exciting! I'm gonna be so... so... Nathaniel, what's a prenuptial agreement?
Just a standard marriage document. Don't worry about it. We'll just go to town hall.
What is it?
Let me read it.
Is this really necessary? I mean, if that's what they gave me at City Hall, then that's what we'll sign, and then they can just marry us.
Corrine! This states that if you sign it, you won't receive any of Nathaniel's money that he had or was assigned to him prior to the marriage if you get a divorce.
But that means you were never going to give me any of the money from the trust fund, were you?
Oh, Corrine, come on, don't be silly. I mean, well, it's my trust fund.
What the hell was I supposed to get out of this?
I hadn't really thought about that.
There we have it.
Oh, you bastard! And to think I was actually going to marry you, you're just as bad as Robert!
You were only marrying me because you thought you were getting half my trust fund.
Well, that's very true. But besides that, the engagement is off. Have fun trying to find another girl to swindle.
Oh, but Corrine, please don't throw this all away.
You're right, Nathaniel. I won't throw it all away. I'm selling the ring.
Oh.
After thoughtful consideration, Nathaniel and I have mutually decided to end our engagement.
Oh, Corrine. If you're not getting married, then I'd like to say something. This whole time you've been with Nathaniel, I realized I was being ridiculous to be embarrassed by dating you. So now, in front of everyone, Corrine, will you be seen in public with me?
Oh, Robert! Go to hell!
Maybe you should have tried singing that ridiculous song.
I told you the engagement is... Oh, you're not Nathaniel.
Who are you?
Call me Mr. Crowley. I work for the collections office at the racetrack.
And what do you want with us?
Nothing with any of you. Unless one of you is Quincy Humoral. His time is up and I've been hired to collect his debts.
Wait, don't leave yet. We've only just signed. Surely you could use a drink. Sarah, he doesn't want to drink.
Oh, no. Like I'm going to wait around here for some unfortunate accident to happen to me. I don't think so. I've gotten what I want, and I've won. And I'm leaving here alive. What on earth is going on here?
Is this Quincy?
Whoa! I'm not Quincy!
Then where the hell is he?
Who wants to know?
I do. Quincy is my employer, owes my employer the money from his life insurance policy, and I've come to collect what he's due. Now tell me where he is.
You're here to collect Quincy's life insurance?
What else would I be doing here with a gun?
You're here to kill Quincy.
That's him!
What?
What?
What are you talking about? I'm not...
Yes! That's Quincy! He's been stealing money from us to gamble with, and I even think he's been stealing from our corpses. What kind of awful, evil, lowlife! Well, I'm glad to turn him over and get him out of our home.
No, I'm not Quincy! Well, wait a minute. So you're Quincy?
No, I'm not Quincy!
Quincy, we told you we weren't going to risk our necks when the bounty hunters came for you.
I've been looking all over for you. It's time you pay up.
Well, wait a minute. You got it all wrong. Maxim, tell him, Maxim. Tell him. I'm not...
take care of business.
Did you?
That's the downside of having someone gamble with life insurance. There's only one way to collect it.
Did you just... How could you?
He was just doing his job. Corrine, we should just let him go.
But he just killed a man for no reason!
No reason? Lady, have you been paying any attention to anything that I've been saying? Quincy Humoral is quite a bit of money.
But that wasn't Quincy!
Would you shut up? What's he talking about? I thought that was Quincy, the one who bet using his life insurance. You told me he was Quincy!
Don't shoot him! That's Quincy. Hey, man. Thanks for the help.
Sorry about this, but Quincy isn't going to be the only one of you that dies tonight. I've got to make sure none of you can talk.
And how are you gonna do that? Oh, God, I got it.
Quincy goes first!
Maxim, do something!
But wait a minute! Let the man have one last drink before he goes. Hmm? In fact, let's all have a final drink.
That's a bright idea.
Quincy, shut up.
Mr. Humoral, I don't think now is the time.
Sure, I could use a drink.
Right?
It's been a long day.
Here we go.
Drink up?
Cheers. You know, I appreciate this. No one ever cares about the bounty hunter. It's always strangle him or shoot her. Never, how are you mentally handling this job? You all are okay. Just a shame I gotta kill you. Right then, let's get this over with. Any last words?
I wish I'd taken up running as my addiction.
All right.
I don't feel so well.
Maybe you should sit down.
What the hell was in that drink?
Just some ice.
Some mead.
And nothing else.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God!
He's dead!
What's dead? But how?
Must have been the drink.
What did he drink?
It was a spiced mead I had bought specifically for tonight.
Well, what the hell was it spiced with?
Almonds.
Huh?
He must have been allergic?
What?
Like Ms. Norcross?
The almonds
seems to be a common allergy in this town.
Why do we have spiced mead? Anyone could have accidentally drank it. It couldn't be.
It was for Mr. Hughes to celebrate.
Celebrate what?
Well, he was... Well, we were keeping it a secret, but Mr. Hughes was going... was signing me on to make me a partner with his funeral homes.
He was? But you said he was buying the parlor.
Robert, how could you have got such a wild idea? He was impressed by the way we kept our parlor afloat in the face of his rising business, and he wanted us to begin working with him.
But since he's dead and I'm his business partner, I guess I own all the parlors myself.
You own all his parlors?
It says so right here in the contract. If either party dies after signing, the other party is then deemed the sole owner of all business assets.
So that means?
That means the Humorals once again own every funeral parlor in the county. But nothing, no poison, and all that's occurred has been heaven sent.
And this luck was enough, for it seems it's all over. Our lives are all saved, thanks to accidents.
Can you all believe what's happened tonight?
Our problems are gone.
There's no trouble in sight.
But isn't it odd, these incidents feel strange?
Arranging someone to die. That's just silly.
Oh, I guess you're right. I mean, it's not like any of you would murder people. I mean, nothing like that ever happens here.
Right. Corrine, would you go and call the police? We could use some help cleaning all this mess up.
Of course.
Cieri, you saved us.
You're welcome.
Would someone explain to me what the hell just happened?
Don't worry. This was all part of the plan that we had. Well, the bet with Mr. Hughes, that is.
But that entire thing with Corrine and Nathaniel and Mr. Crowley showing up.
We didn't plan for any of that.
So I was actually in danger.
Relax, Quincy. Everything worked out. And if it hadn't been for your bounty hunter, Mr. Hughes would have left without celebrating his success with a poison drink.
Speaking of, how did you convince him to sign you on as a business partner?
Oh, that's simple. We didn't. See our luck that we struck, called for lies and deception, but now here we stand with nothing to fear.
Yes, our luck wasn't luck, and we staged this whole evening for our benefit. It was all engineered.
We forged a fake contract.
We swapped and we signed.
That states if he dies then
his homes are all mine.
And now that we own the parlors in each town, we're shutting them down.
Low supply means high prices.
If anyone wants a funeral, they'll have to come here.
And there'll be no more murdering.
All taken care of, Mr. Humoral. What was that about murdering?
Should we tell her?
I think it's best we don't. She's better left in the dark.
I agree.
And as the months flew by, they all rejoiced. Mr. Hughes was gone. No one had any choice. All they had was
and we're in our prime.
This luck shows we're tough.
We can handle our problems.
It's all thanks to you and our fatal crimes. We've no competition, not one single place within our whole county.
They've all been erased. The only morticians left for funerals are us humorals. It's quite beautiful for us humorals. Quite wonderful. For us humor.
Excuse me, we're right in the middle of the finale.
My apologies. I didn't mean to interrupt. My name is Miss Hayes, and I wanted to introduce myself. You see, I just bought the vacant house down the street.
Oh, well, welcome to the neighborhood.
Thank you. Yes, I thought it was the perfect location with such a high death rate.
What's a high death rate perfect for, I mean?
Oh, forgive me. I'm opening up a funeral home of my own.
What? You're opening up a...
Indeed, I am. The market in this town was just prime for more funeral homes. I wanted to come by and introduce myself. Yes, I'm looking forward to some nice, healthy competition. Perhaps we are through.
Do we all want to go through again what we did with Mr. Hughes?
I mean, it's only one parlor.
Think of before, when only one parlor became so much more.
I thought that it was, but this is not the end.
So what are you saying?
Perhaps we need some more accidents. Miss Hayes, why don't you come in and have a seat? We'd love to get to know you.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, of course. That sounds excellent.
How do you take yours?
I like mine with extra milk.
Wonderful!
I thought